Welcome back. If you're new here, hey, I'm Melissa. Today we've got a detailed look at four platforms you might use to host your online classes. Some of them offer additional services like invoicing using Stripe or PayPal, but all of them go beyond just the basic meeting space. I'll leave timestamps in the description just in case you're looking for info on a specific teaching platform. As an online teacher, the way that you serve up your classes can really make a difference to the families you serve. Think about the various ways we interact with them. The actual teaching, the invoicing, the communications, the scheduling. Let's try to pick a platform where we add value to this process and not just a bunch of steps. Again, check the timestamps in the description in case you're looking for something specific, and stick around till the end to hear my personal favorite. Let's go. First up, we've got KoalaGo. Koala has a bunch of unique features which will make it a favorite for teachers who have younger learners. People love Koala for the playground, an interactive space where your students can run around with their avatar and interact with different activities that you have prepared ahead of time. Koala is a really agile company, which is something we can really appreciate as online teachers as they change and listen to suggestions. They also offer invoicing features using PayPal or Stripe to invoice families worldwide using WeChat, Pay, or Alipay, or other payment methods. You don't even need to be Stripe verified to do this, which is awesome. Koala works well with lots of integrations like WordWall, WYSIMO, Jamboard. In case you're already using those, you can go ahead and slide those right into your Koala lessons. As for pricing, the Koala Pro plan comes in at about $19 a month. Our next teaching platform is LiveBoard. This tool has all the basics, but it has some huge perks for teachers, including the price, which may have you starstruck by the end. LiveBoard is an interactive whiteboard that works similar to Nearpod, where you send your students a code, free of charge, they'll enter the board, and then when it's time to start class, you just initiate the video call. There is free, unlimited cloud recording. This is huge for sharing recordings with families so that you don't need to pay for extra storage on places like Google Drive or WeTransfer or Dropbox. STEM tutors and teachers will love the integrations that help make formulas, graphs, and symbols seamless and beautiful. No wonky drawings anymore. This is the real deal. LiveBoard has a chat box and screen sharing, and you can easily import PDFs or images to make worksheets and other materials interactive. Something unique to LiveBoard is the status band feature. This can tell you if your students are looking at another tab or if they've signed off. This is great for class management. LiveBoard also has an invoicing feature using Stripe or PayPal. LiveBoard is the most cost-effective of these four options that I'm bringing to you today, and the annual plan comes in at just $9.99 a month. Up next is ClassIn. This is a very familiar tool for students in Asia, as the company itself is based in China, and it makes it a perennial favorite for teachers with a lot of Asian-based students. ClassIn allows for a shared browser, lots of integrations, and invoicing. The workspace has tons of features like document storage, so you can pull up your images and resources in class seamlessly. It also has a chat box, onstage features, breakout rooms. It also has a scheduling feature that many teachers find helpful when working with multiple students. If you've got large groups or a unique situation with interactive curriculum, ClassIn likely has what you're looking for. As far as pricing, buckle up. ClassIn has a free version, but it also has a pro plan, which comes in two formats. The consumption model comes in around $15 a month, and the $20 a month option of a subscription model might be better for those with a larger student base. You'll want to check out which plan is best for you based on how much you teach. Cloud recording costs extra in case that's something you lean on. If all this sounds super confusing to you, I've gone ahead and left a link to a blog post from Tim at Online Teacher Dude. He has put this together to help with specific examples so that you can figure out which plan might be right for you. Tim's also got a 20% discount code in there. Lastly, we've got good old Zoom. Let's be honest, we've all had our share of Zoom over the past few years, whether we were teaching on it or not. The intuitive screen sharing, whiteboard, chat box, and virtual backgrounds make for a basic way to get class done. Also, the ability to record locally or to the cloud is great for licensed users until you hit the storage limit for cloud recordings. Unfortunately, for students who live in countries where the Zoom app is not accessible, there may be limits on the interactive tools that they have access to, like annotating. For some, this isn't an issue. What has become an issue is the 40-minute limit on the free plan. I should mention, many of the teachers I've talked to have kept right on using that free plan and have simply mentioned to their students, I'm going to need to end class and then restart it real quick. And this minimal interruption is not a big deal for them in order to continue using Zoom for free. A Zoom Pro license comes in at around $13 per month for an annual plan. I should mention for comparison's sake that there are no invoicing, scheduling, or communication features with Zoom to use for families. Simply a link to share, but you already knew that. All right, have you made your choice? Overall differences in pricing, integrations, global availability, and special features for STEM users stick out to me as things that might help us lean one way or another. Now, I promise to share my favorite platform. If you've been following along on Instagram with my teaching journey, where I share much more of what I do on the daily, you may have seen me posting about my recent switch from Zoom to LiveBoard. My private tutoring students, while I'm not a STEM tutor, really enjoy the ability to interact freely on LiveBoard with the material that I upload there. The families that I work with also really appreciate having ready access to the recordings of our class. Also, the price! As I mentioned, this is the most cost-effective option out there that I've seen. Prove me wrong in the comments if you've got another paid option that you found elsewhere. As I'm such a fan, I would love for you to try it too. I'm going to leave my affiliate link in the description as well as the code Melissa20 to get 20% off of their premium plan. If this has been helpful to you, it would be super helpful to me if you would go ahead and subscribe and like this video. That helps to make sure you don't miss next week's video. And why wait? Go ahead and watch this one now. Yeah.